champion, we take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us. Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day. We all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. So wave your flag, now wave your flag, now wave your flag. Oh, take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us.
Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day. We all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. So wave your flag, now 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 wave your flag.
It surrounds us, every nation. All-
choosing your battles. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh, oh, and if you fold it up, eh, eh, mina, sangalewa, cause this is Africa. Samina, mina, eh, eh, waka, waka, eh, eh, samina, mina, sangalewa, this time for Africa. For Africa. Samina, mina, eh, eh, waka, waka, eh, eh, samina, mina, sakalewa, anawa, ah, ah, samina, mina, eh, eh, waka, waka, eh, eh, samina, mina, sakalewa, it's time for Africa.
Yeah.
make the field them. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting as we lose our inhibition. Celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us.
Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day, we all said, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. So wave your flag, now wave your flag, now wave your flag.
Italian skulls.
How it's supposed to look. Yes!
Thank you.
yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's off, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fall, get up, oh, oh, and if you fall, get up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa, cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. This time for Africa. Listen to your guide, this is our motto. Your time to shine, don't wait in line. Y vamos por todo. People are raising their expectations. Go on and feed them, this is your moment, no hesitation. Today's your day, I feel it. You pave the way, believe it. If you get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. Anawa, ah, ah. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. For Africa.
I'm way on my journey, biggie, biggie mama, one A to Z. My tea so sell on my journey, biggie, biggie mama, from east to west. My tea, waka, waka, my A, eh, eh. Waka, waka, my A, eh, eh. Sang this is so mazibu, yeah. Cause this is Africa.
And it was very well deserved. And it was an easy choice coming into this year to have Alex be one of the captains, just because of the way he was last year. While he was, I don't want to say just a junior, but in terms of things, it's rare to have a junior step up and be kind of one of the leaders on the team. Whether it be just a cultural thing or because, the seniors, whatever it is, Alex made it easy last year coming into this year to kind of choose him to be one of the captains. There's not enough good things I can say about Alex. He was a coach on the field for us. He was a coach on the sideline. We couldn't have got where we got this year without Alex. He's one of those players that you're really going to miss, one of those true captains that kind of takes over and does what you need him to do on the field. Sorry. I get emotional.
He's coming back.
I get emotional at these things. I hate losing players,
drop a couple grand.
Whether it be at practice, whether it be in film, Alex would step up. There were times in film when he would point out things that the coaches, didn't see. You could tell he was going home and watching it and figuring things out and figuring out what we could do better. And he's insightful. Alex was one of those players that you, as a coach, you could run things through. And, given that he was on the field, he sees things from a different perspective, and you could trust his opinion and what he was going to say. A lot of times, throughout the season, I've asked multiple boys, probably almost every boy on the team, what they thought about this little adjustment I wanted to make. And, sometimes it's a test. Sometimes I'll ask a player, I'll throw one of their friends in the mix and say, hey, what do you think about starting this guy over this guy? Just to kind of see what they say, and if they choose their friend and the friend's not the obvious choice, then I kind of know not to ask this guy next time. But Alex would never do that. Alex was honest. He wanted what was best for the team. When we would get ahead in games, everyone may not know this, but Alex wasn't supposed to play this season. He has actually a pretty bad hip injury that he's been playing through all season long. And because of that, he couldn't defend very well when it came to defending and came to getting back on defense. It just wasn't in the cards. He just couldn't get back that fast or as fast as he normally could, or as fast as some of the other guys could who were healthy. And then those times in the game, Alex would say, "Coach, you've got to take me off. I'm not going to be able to get back and defend. Give someone else this opportunity." And it's very rare to see in high school boys soccer is people asking to come off the field, especially when you're one of the players that are they're scoring goals or one of the top assist getters. It's very rare to see. And he always wanted what was best for the team, and he was always kind of willing to sacrifice for that. And it's going to be very hard to replace you, so thank you, Alex. If you haven't seen Dawson play, I highly recommend you go watch him at the next level, wherever that may be. Dawson is easily the most exciting player that I've ever seen, hands down, on a soccer field. Probably through almost any sport, I could say that it was a real pleasure being able to watch Dawson. It was hard to coach Dawson at times because you just wanted to watch him. Just wanted to see what he would do when he got the ball at his feet. You almost forgot about the rest of the field when that happened. And it took me a while, even last year to do that, to not just watch Dawson once he got the ball, because it was, you can tell everyone was doing it. The players in the field were doing it. We've had many conversations as a team throughout the past 2 years. How we can't just watch when Dawson gets the ball. We'll watch it on film later, and it will be just as exciting. We have the work and we have the coach while he gets the ball, despite how hard it is, despite how much you want to see what he does next, because it's probably, you blink and you'll miss it. It's Dawson again. Dawson is the type of leader that leads with his play. At the beginning of the year and at summer conditioning, first day, I talked to Dawson. But the first day, Dawson was not in the front of the pack. He was kind of running with his buddies, kind of in the middle, kind of hanging towards the back, like anyone his age would do, for the most part. After that training, or as I was running through it, I said, "Dawson, I'm keeping up with you. This should be impossible. I'm out of shape. I should not be able to keep up with you." I pulled him off to the side. We talked about, what he was going to have to do this year to be a dream team player for us to make it past the district finals. We were going to look to him and we were going to lean on him. He was going to have to respond. And from that day out, he never slowed down. He was never at the middle of the pack again. Quite frankly, he was usually done before the rest of us started. He's that fast, that strong, that conditioned where, he really lived up to that, and he took it to the next level, and that's what he needed to do this season, and he did, because we did make it past districts, and he did make it to the dream team. I know that was one of his goals, and it was one of my goals for him. I think that was one of our team goals, was to be represented at that kind of a level. And Dawson took those reins, and he led with his play. A lot of players with his kind of ability that you see going to net will go down a lot. You see it in the pros, you see it everywhere. They'll try to draw fouls. One thing with Dawson that I can't have enough respect for, and I'm sure all of you know this, is the kid never went down when he could have. He probably could have got a penalty kick every time he had the ball. But he never went down. He stayed up. He wanted to show everyone how strong he was and how good he was. And he truly did that this season. And he did it in a respectable way where he wasn't taking dives, where he wasn't getting cheap goals through penalty kicks. And I don't think we'll ever see another player quite like him again. Obviously, there will be good players with other skills and other great players, and I'm sure there will be other Dream Team players, and we may even have a couple of those within us, you know, right now. But we'll never quite see another player like you in Dawson. So thank you. So far. I know that some of these parents around the room worked really hard on making this night possible. Specifically, I want to give a shout out to Mrs. Reyes and Mrs. Strom and, you know, everybody else who contributed to making this night possible. So let's give them a round of applause. Alright, so to just give a little background about myself before I get into our season. I've been playing soccer ever since, you know, I can remember, and I started playing for Stevenson during my sophomore year. However, I don't actually attend Stevenson during the school day. I go to a different program that's offered in our district, which means I don't get to see all of these guys every single day. That being said, some of these guys on the team are, you know, some of my best friends. The relationships I've made because of this program is something that I'm always going to remember and I'm going to cherish for the rest of my life. Because at the end of the day, this whole experience is bigger than soccer. It's about becoming better people, and you know, to be able to do it with your teammates is something that I'm really grateful for. I can't say enough about each and every one of the guys on our team this year. Both on and off the field, and some of my greatest memories will be because of this program. So as I previously mentioned, I started playing for Stevenson during my sophomore year, and at the time, Coach Foster wasn't our coach. It wasn't until the beginning of my junior year when he was implemented as the varsity soccer coach. And I have a little story to share about the first time I met him. It was with the last year's captains, and as well as Dawson, and it was just like a little meet and greet session with him to kind of, you know, get to know what he was about and what he wanted to do with our team this season. And the first thing we did was shake his hand, and I remember this was the one thing I still remember is that the grip of his handshake was so strong that I thought he was going to break my hand every time I shook his. And I know some of the other guys thought this too, and Coach is probably sitting there thinking, well, like, you know, I never remember you telling me this. Well, this is my first time bringing it up. So, you know, this was it was the first thing I kind of noticed about him. And as we got into our little meeting that we were having, he was talking about the things he wanted to implement into our program. And one of the things was physical training, a lot of physical training. And if there's one thing you know about me, it's that I'm not the most athletic guy in the field, and I definitely don't like running. So some of you can imagine, the first time I met him, I'm like, all right, great, I'm going to hate this guy. I want to not even play for the school anymore at that point. No, I'm just kidding. On a serious note, it's the exact opposite of what I think of him now. As I got to know him over the past 2 years, I really started to appreciate the amount of work that he put in as a coach. And as players, we can really tell what the time he takes out of his own day to try and improve our team. Whether it was him editing film for us, or him thinking about tactics for the next game we had, or even him doing all the physical activities he made us do alongside us. It's something as a player that you begin to really notice about a coach, and you gain more and more respect for him as you're a player under him. So that being said, Coach, I want to thank you for everything that you've done for our team and our program for the past 2 seasons. I can't picture them being anything in comparison to what they were without you being in charge. And I'd also like to give a quick thank you to Coach Casale and Coach Newcomb. These two guys were at every playoff game, whether it was, you know, a nice weather, or it was like it was in our regional semifinals, mid-40s, rain coming sideways, and they were there at every game. So let's give a round of applause to the students. Next, I want to focus on one of the guys in particular on our team this year, Dawson. He and I have been playing together ever since we were about 6 or 7 years old, and he's going to be one of the guys that I really miss playing with as I get older. We've been able to develop chemistry on the soccer field that I've never really had with another player before, and this year when he won Dream Team, I couldn't have been more happy for him. Seeing the work that he put in over the summer, going to the conditioning camps like Coach said, and the determination he had to try and get Dream Team this year and be, you know, one of the leading guys of our team, it was just an honor to be able to play alongside him and see him get Dream Team. I couldn't have been more happy for him. So, Doss, I mean, I love you, man, and I'm really going to miss playing with you. As for the rest of the guys, sorry, I'll get some round of applause after. As for the rest of the guys, you guys should all be very, very proud of what we were able to accomplish this season. After taking one of those huge dips that Coach was talking about at the end of our regular season, we were able to bounce back and go all the way to regional finals, and because of all your determination, we were able to turn the season around. It was a great way to end the year, and hopefully you juniors and sophomores were able to learn something from the journey we had this year, and you guys can hopefully improve in your next season and do even more next year. Also, I'd like to give Dylan, the captain alongside Dawson and I, a shout out as well. Dylan is only a junior this year, and he's one of the most talented kids, talented defenders I've ever played with, frankly. So to the varsity team next year, I wish you guys the best of luck. So let's give a quick round of applause to the players. To thank all the parents of all the teams. For varsity, we have pasta parties the day before every game, and usually every parent has at least one pasta party hosted at their house, and some even have more. So thank you to all the parents for hosting those. On behalf of myself and the players, we really appreciate that you guys did that for us. And for all the rest of the parents, we'd like to thank you for the support you guys have given all the teams for Stevenson throughout this past season. Some of the parents were every single game, rain or shine, hot or cold, and it's something that as players we get motivated to see support in the crowds, especially from the ones we love most. So once again, we'd really like to thank you for all that you've done this past season. Lastly, I'd like to give a special thank you to my own parents. My mom and dad are, and have, and will always will be, hopefully, my biggest supporters. Without their support, I wouldn't be anywhere near where I'm at today. And, you know, whether it was my dad driving me to every game as since I can remember playing soccer, it was my mom washing my soccer clothes every week for the past 7 years, they're the reasons why I've been able to accomplish everything I have throughout my entire life. So I could go on and on about all the things that they've done for me, but for the sake of time, I'll leave it at that. Mom, Dad, I love you guys. Thank you for everything.
Thank you.
Nothing but exciting moments for me. I cannot thank my parents and my coaches throughout the years for all they have done for me and helped me grow as a player that I've become today. I will miss every moment of this excitement and for playing for Stevenson, and hopefully I continue my soccer career and college and continue those exciting moments. Dad and Mom, thank you for everything that you have done for me. I wouldn't become the player that I have become today from all you guys driving me to soccer practices, Mom washing my clothes, and I know I'm a handful with trying to hang out with all my friends and sleeping over everywhere every day. Thank you for always putting up with me, and I love you more than anything. Also, to my second parents, Mr. Bob and Miss Elizabeth, thank you for also putting up with me, and Alex, who always kept you up late at night, and I would always eat your fruit roll-ups, and the toaster strudels, Yeah, I can never forget those. Couldn't ask for a better second chance. And I'll be over there more, watching some football with Alex and you, Mr. Bob. And maybe asking Alex for some homework help. I need that too for AP site. And I'll always miss Mr. Bob on the film. Listening to those comments that he makes during the game. Always a good laugh during the film. So love you both, and thank you for everything you showed for me.
Thank you.
Next, Coach Foster. You came in the program the last 2 years, and I don't think we would have had accomplished anywhere close to what we have done in the last 2 years with if you hadn't came coach. From all the stuff that you do, from doing the conditioning camps with us, it's been unreal. I've never seen a coach do all the, like, run with us and all that stuff. Edit film for us, mind you, I have no disrespect to him at all, but like, he never had someone record the games for us, or always like set up a group chat for us to send us text before the game, hyping us up before the game. So I appreciate everything that you've done for us, and I wish you the best of luck in the next years to come, Ms. Stevenson. Hopefully you make it as far as we did, maybe even win a state championship. I'd also like to thank Papa Foster over there for the conditioning camps. Even though I wanted to kill myself every day, they actually really helped. Something that I've never done before, actually. And it was honestly the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. All the kids, the London classmen, juniors, freshmen, sophomores, I would advise you to go to those because they actually help a lot with your conditioning. And you know, I don't think I would have been able to play every minute or however long I've played like during the games if I hadn't went to those conditioning. So thank you very much. Next is a very special teammate of mine, Alex. I'm going to miss playing with you, buddy. Miss crossing those balls into you with your big head over there. All those assists you gave me from just sweating the ball into you and you finishing them off. We built a connection over the years that we played that I've never had with a teammate. I wish you the best of luck in the future. Wherever you end up in college, I'm sure it will be U of M or Michigan State, somewhere smart. And I'm hoping you can continue carrying my fantasy team like you have been, and help me with my homework. Yeah. And to all the teammates that were with me this year, I thank you. I couldn't thank you enough. Dream Team, I couldn't have gotten it without you guys. It's been an honor playing with you guys, and I wish you the best of luck next year. I know it wasn't the season that we hoped for in the MAC Red, but every game we played our hearts out, and I couldn't ask for more. During the end of the year, yeah, we struggled, but in the playoffs, we knew what we had to do, and I couldn't ask for more. We ended up going to regional finals and just came up a little bit short. I believe that if we won that game, we could have had a chance at the state championship. And hopefully next year you guys can win the state champions for us seniors and you guys next year as well. So I wish you all the underclassmen the best of luck, and thank you all.
Today, bringing me to the U.S. for a brighter future, for a better life. I'm also thankful for our coach, Trevor Foster, and our team for helping me get and push harder so where I'm at today. It's truly been an honor to be with and play with all you guys, even if it was only for a year. It felt more to me. And what I want all the underclassmen and everybody else to do for the rest of their soccer careers, if you want to continue on the next level, is to push harder, go the extra mile, do what the next person won't do. Just work hard, and you'll probably, hopefully, get where you want to be when you... That's it for me.
Okay, thank you.
Alright, I want to thank all the parents for coming out to all our games, and I especially want to thank my parents. I love you guys, and I appreciate everything that you guys do for me. I also want to say thank you to Coach Foster for such a great season and for leading the team to the district title. It means a lot to all of us. I want to thank all of our captains for setting good examples and really improving the team all around. Thank you guys. Also, thank you to all my teammates for a great season and making my senior year the best. Some advice that I would have for the younger players is to give it your all. And even if you think something is impossible, know that you guys can do it as long as you work together and you can accomplish the goals. Work hard and it will pay off in the end. I have had a great time playing soccer at Stevenson, especially this year. And I have had so many great memories with all you guys. I'll really miss seeing all you guys on the field do big things next year. Thank you guys.
Hi everyone. I just wanted to say that I'm very thankful and proud that I was able to play for Stevenson Varsity Soccer for my last year of high school. I want to thank all the parents for coming and supporting our games. I also want to give a big thanks to my teammates for making this such a great experience. And for all the younger players who are going to play next year, try your best, but never forget to have fun. Also, thanks for all the coaches helping us all to grow better this season, and I hope I could have been played since the beginning. Thinking back to all the memories from this season, my favorite was that I scored in our first game. It was a great start to the season, and I also how we all work together to get this far and win district. Thank you for making this one of the best years of high school.
Last but not least, Rudy